In many cases, we want to display values for counters, sensors, and other debug information. Although there is LCD on the discovery kit, it can only display 6 characters simultaneously. Fortunately, we have another nice option that uses ST-Link V2.1 interface. This option does not require any extra hardware. You can see there's only one USB cable connect here. We're not using the other USB cable, USB interface here. The main function of ST-Link is to flash and debug the ARM processors through the mini USB interface. In addition, ST-Link version 2.1 also provides a USB COM port. This virtual COM port, also called UR port, allows PC and the Discover Kit to exchange information via the terminal emulator. Let's take a look at the schematics. This is ST-Link version 2.1. In fact, it's a Cortex M0 processor. Let's pay attention, pin PA2, PA3. PA3, ST-Link RX, there are two possible connections, URTX, MFX UR3TX, and PA3, ST-Link TX, there are two possible connections, MFX UR3RX, URRX. And those connections are controlled by 4 solder bridges, SB13, 16, 15, 17. By default, solder bridge 13 and 16 are soldered. Therefore, PA2 is connected to URTRX, PA3 is connected to URTX. Let's take a look at URRX and URTX. If we go to the next page of the schematics, you can see here URTX, URRX, they're connected to pin PD5 and PD6 respectively. And let's examine what alternate function PD5 and PD6 should be. If you go to the textbook's website, go to Example Labs, look at the STM Discover Kit with STM32L4, and if you take a look at the pin functions, you can either look at the Excel file or PDF. Let's take a look at the PDF. And the first row shows alternating function number from AF0 to AF15. And the first column shows the pin name, PA0, PA1. Let's take a look at PD5 and PD6. Here are PD5, PD6. They are set should be UR2 TX, UR2 RX. Let's go all the way up to look at what function number, alternating function number it should be. It should be alternating function number 7. Let's take a look at example code. Here's the demo code. And in this demo code, I'm initialize the system clock and initialize the LED and initialize UR2. Let's take a UR. The UR is PD5, PD6 as UR2. That's the transmission and the receiver. Set as alternative function 7. And the UR initialization, I initialize the UR2 as asynchronous mode 9600 baud rate, no parity, 8 data bit, 1 stop bit, no hardware flow control. Now let's go back to the main program. In the main program, I use sprintf to print an integer a into a string buffer, and then a floating number b into string buffer, and then use UR write from to write the data to the UR port. Then update A and B and a for loop delay, and then toggle LED. That's what you see here. I have the board is running, the LED is flashing, and the data is printed here. Let's see how we set up the terminal emulator. And I'm using Taro term as example. Let me close it and restart. So let me download the code to stop the program and close the terminal. When you plug your Discover Kit to your computer, it will have a COM port. On my computer, it shows as ST-Link Virtual COM 3. It might be a different COM number on your computer. So let me open the terminal, and I select serial. I'll select COM3 ST-Link, click OK, and then we change the font size, make it a little bit larger, and before I start, make sure that you have the right setting. And for example, here, if you go to setup, serial port, it has COM3, 9600, 8-bit, non-parity, 1-stop bit, no hardware flow control. So if I download the program, let me download the program, and click reset button, you see information is printed on the terminal. This example shows you a nice way for you to print debugging information on the terminal. Next, I'm going to show you how we can transfer information from the virtual terminal to the board. So let me comment out of this code and uncomment this part of code and save it, compile it, same time, I'm going to clear the buffer. Let me download the program. Okay. Clear buffer. So let me reset the processor. And look at the code here. This one first use UR write to print a string, basically require user's inputs, provides hints for user to type N to turn off the LED, or Y and turn on the LED. So after we write this string to the terminal, and we're going to use UR read to receive a byte from the terminal. If we type N, it will turn off LED and confirm LED has been turned off by using UR write. And if it is Y, and then turn on LED and confirm LED has been turned on. Let me show you a demo. And I'm going to highlight this window. I'm going to type Y. You see here, LED is on. I'm going to type N, LED is off. So look at here, the LED, Y on, N off. So this example shows that we can also send information from the terminal to the Discover Kit. Let's go back to look at schematic file. And by default, the ST-Link UR, TX, and RX are connected to UR, RX, and UR, TX. And then another possible connection, which is which we can connect them to MFXUR3RX and MFXUR3TX respectively. So what are they? MF stands for multiple function unit. Let's look at the board. And in fact, this is MFX. It's another Cortex-M processor. And it's put there, it's trying to measure the power consumption of STM32L4 here. And this, we can also let ST-Link to talk to this processor by changing the solder bridge instead of talking to this one. But one thing we need to pay attention is, in this example, I use polling method to send data and receive data. If you look at here, it's UR read. I'll wait until receive buffer not empty. When I'm sending the data, I'll wait until transmission buffer is empty. The polling method is very inefficient. If we cannot use this method too often in a busy program, because this will impact your processor application performance. To improve the efficiency, we can rewrite the code by using the UR or DMA. And if needed, we might even need a real-time operating system to reduce the impact of the communication on the impact of the UR communication on your application performance.